Dear children, today's topic is Huckel rule of aromaticity. We know the conditions for aromaticity. If a compound is said to be aromatic, that should obey some rules. These are the conditions. They should be cyclic, planar, then conjugated, then that should obey Huckel rule. What is Huckel rule? Huckel rule is 4n plus 2 pi electrons rule. That means the total number of pi electrons in a compound should satisfy the Huckel rule. For example, if there are only 2 pi electrons in a system, so 4n plus 2 equal to 2. So n is an integer that can be from 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. So if the total number of pi electrons is 2, means n should be n equal to 0. So when you are putting n equal to 0, so 4 into 0 plus 2, that equal to 2 pi electrons. So Huckel rule is obeyed, then only that compound is said to be aromatic. And if suppose the total number of electron is 6, 6 pi electrons are there, then the value of n equal to 1. So 4 multiply 1 plus 2 is 6 pi electrons. So if a compound satisfy all these conditions, then only that compound is said to be aromatic. So we already know aromatic compounds are cyclic, planar, and possess 4n plus 2 pi electrons. That types of compounds are said to be aromatic. Then another type of compounds are anti-aromatic compounds. What are anti-aromatic compounds? These are also cyclic, planar, and possess 4n pi electrons. So if it is 4n plus 2 pi electrons, that is said to be aromatic, and if it is having only 4n pi electrons, that type of compounds is said to be anti-aromatic. N is an integer like 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. So here I have given some examples, and let us check using the Huckel's rule whether it is aromatic or anti-aromatic. First one is benzene. So here how many pi electrons are here? You see, this 1, 2, 1 pi electron, 1 double bonds means 2 pi electrons, 1, 2, 3, 4, then 5, 6. So total 6 electrons are here. So when you are occupying this 4n plus 2 pi electrons, what is the value of n? If it is total 6 pi electrons, n should be 1. So total 6 electrons are here, so it is aromatic. Other conditions we will explain later. So here this one is cyclopentadienyl anion. So here anions means that is having one lone pair of electrons. So total number of pi electrons is 1, 2, 3, 4, and these two lone pairs should also be involved in bonding. That will also participate in resonance. Then only that compound will show aromaticity. So total number of electrons is 1, 2, 3, 4, and this lone pair also will be participating. So total 6 pi electrons are here, and that is aromatic. And this compound is cyclobutadiene. How many pi electrons are here? 1, 2, 3, 4. Total 4 pi electrons are here. So this will not satisfy Huckel's rule, 4n plus 2. We cannot put it as 4 because it should not be a fraction. It is only an integer. N should be an integer. And this will satisfy only 4n. N equal to 1. So this one is anti-aromatic. Next one is cyclopentadiene. Here there is no anion, there is no cation. So here what happened? Total number of pi electrons is 1, 2, 3, 4. Total 4 electrons are here. So it should be anti-aromatic. But you know aromatic, it should be cyclic and planar and having conjugate double bonds. So it is cyclic and this is not planar. If it is planar, all the carbon atoms should be sp2. Here we know because of double bond, these two carbon atoms and these two are sp2. But here there is no double bond, so it is not sp2, it is sp3. So it is not cyclic. Sorry, it is not planar. Then another condition is conjugate double bonds. Here we know conjugate double bonds means it should be having alternate single and double bonds. So here one double bond, then single bond, then again another single bond is there. So there is no conjugated double bonds and single bonds, so it is not aromatic. Another one is cyclooctatetraene. Cyclooctatetraene having all conjugate double bonds are here. Total number of pi electrons, 2, 4, 6, 8. Total 8 pi electrons are here, so that will not satisfy Huckel's rule, but that can be satisfied with 4n pi electrons. So that compound is said to be anti-aromatic. Next is the applications of Huckel's rule. we know there are two types of compounds that obey Huckel rule or aromaticity. First one is benzenoid compounds and the other one is non-benzenoid compounds. What are benzenoid compounds? We know benzene is the simplest aromatic hydrocarbon. Compounds containing benzene or its alkyl substituted homologous or polynuclear hydrocarbons are known as benzenoid compounds. Example is toluene, nitrobenzene, then naphthalene, anthracene, etc. Then another types of compounds. These compounds also exhibit this aromatic character, but they will not be having benzene-like structure. So without benzene, some compounds are there that also will be aromatic. That types of compounds are known as non-benzenoid compounds. An example for this type of compounds are heterocyclic compounds, azulenes, then some aromatic ions. These types of compounds will not be having like cyclopropenyl cation. This will not be having benzene-like structure, but that will exhibit aromaticity. Now let us discuss conditions of aromaticity with some examples. The first one is benzenoid compounds and the first example is benzene. So here we know the first condition is it should be cyclic. We know in benzene all the carbon atoms are in the ring, so it is cyclic compound. The next one is it should be planar. How we know the compound is planar or not? If a compound is planar, that should be having either sp2 hybridization or sp hybridization. So if a compound will satisfy sp or sp2, that types of compounds will satisfy planarity. So here we know double bond will be having sp2 hybridization and a triple bond will be having sp hybridization. So here each carbon atom is double bond. Here it is double bond, so this carbon atom will be sp2. So each double bonded carbon atom will be having sp2 hybridization. So this one sp2 means this also will be sp2. And this carbon atom also sp2, here this one sp2, and this carbon atom sp2, this carbon atom also sp2. So each carbon atom, all the six carbon atoms in benzene are sp2 hybridized. So this one is a planar compound. Another one is conjugated double bonds. Here we know conjugate means alternate single and double bonds. So in a benzene, this one is double bond, single bond, again double bond, single bond, double bond, single bond. So here these all the carbon atoms are conjugated and here electrons are delocalized inside the ring. So the third condition also satisfied. The fourth condition is it should obey Huckel rule. Huckel rule is 4n plus 2 pi electron. The system should possess 4n plus 2 pi electrons. Here you see how many pi electrons are here? One pi bond means two pi electrons are here. So this one is 1, 2, then 3, 4, 5, 6. Total 6 pi electrons are here. So 4n plus 2 means 6 pi electrons. Then the value of n, we know n is an integer, so the value of n is 1. So 4 multiply 1 plus 2 is 6 electrons. Therefore, benzene is an aromatic compound. So next compound is naphthalene. In the case of naphthalene, we'll see these are cyclic compounds. So the first condition is satisfied. These are cyclic. All the compounds are inside the ring. Then planar. Planar means either sp2 or sp hybridization. These here all the carbon atoms here inside the ring. It is double bond and single. So double bond means that is sp2 hybridization. So this carbon atom is sp2. This carbon atom is sp2. Here sp2. This also sp2 and here also double bond, that means sp2, here sp2, this carbon is sp2, here sp2. All the carbon atoms in naphthalene are sp2 hybridized. All the carbon atoms in naphthalene are sp2 hybridized. So sp2 hybridized means it will be having a planar structure. The ring will be in the plane and all the hydrogen atoms also will be in the plane. sp2 means it has a trigonal planar structure. Next is Huckel rule. Huckel rule, total number of pi electrons 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. Total 5 pi bonds are here. So total number of pi electrons is 10. So n will be 2. 4 multiply 2 plus 2 is 10 electrons. So that satisfies Huckel rule also. So naphthalene is an aromatic compound. So next one is anthracene. The first condition is cyclic. Here all the atoms are inside the ring. Then next one is planar. We know this here all the carbon atoms are sp2 hybridized. So this one is a planar compound. Then the next is conjugate double bond. Here we know in all the atoms, or here in anthracene, bonds are in alternate position. Double bond and single bond are in the alternate position. So here double bond, then single bond, again double bond, single bond. So here atoms are arranged in, double bonds are arranged in conjugate position. So it is delocalized. Electrons are delocalized inside the ring. Then next is Huckel rule. Huckel rule, total number of pi electrons here is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 double bond mean total 14 electrons are here. 1 double bond is 2 electrons. So 4 multiply 3 plus 2 is 14. So n equal to 3. So this anthracene obey Huckel rule. Therefore anthracene is an aromatic compound. Next type of aromatic compounds are non-benzenoid compounds. Non-benzenoid compounds means that will possess aromaticity but will lack the structure of benzene in their structures. So that are three types of compounds are here. The first one is aromatic ions, then heterocyclic compounds, and the third one is anilines. So under non-benzenoid compounds, the first one is aromatic ions. First example is cyclopentadienyl anion. We will see here whether this compound is aromatic. The first condition is cyclic. This compound is cyclic because all the atoms are inside the ring. Next is planar. A compound is said to be planar if it satisfies sp2 or sp hybridization. We know double bonded carbon atoms are in sp2 hybridization. So this carbon atom is sp2. Here if a carbon atom is in double bond, then it is having sp2. Then this carbon atom also sp2 hybridization, this one also sp2 hybridization, this one also sp2 hybridization. And what about this one? This is a lone pair. This is a lone pair, or it's an anion. So here this lone pair will be participate in the bonding. Then only it will satisfy delocalized pi electrons, because here there are two, then single bond, then should be double bond. Here there is no double bond, and instead of the double bond there is one lone pair of electron is there. We know total bonds or the valency of the carbon atom is 4. So here only 1, 2 bonds are here, then one lone pair is there. So total 3 is over, then one more is there, that one is hydrogen. So and one more bond is here, that is hydrogen. So the fourth valency is satisfied by hydrogen atom. So total how many bonds are here? 1, 2, and 3. Total 3 bonds are here, and see here 1, 2, and 3. So 3 sigma bonds. 3 sigma bonds means that is also having sp2 hybridization. So here this lone pair is not available for this carbon atom. That is why only 3 sigma bonds are here, or 3 are sigma bonds. Total sp2 hybridization means 3 hybrid orbitals will be here. So 3 hybrid orbitals, one is this one is second, and this one is third one. This lone pair we cannot count. Why we cannot count? This lone pair is used for resonance to this cyclopentadiene ring. Then only that will satisfy this delocalized double bonds rule. So if it is planar, all the carbon atoms should be sp2 hybridized. So what is the hybridization of this carbon? This carbon also will be sp2. Why it is sp2? Sp2 means 3 hybrid orbitals are here. So 1, 2 and this one is 3. So these 3 are bond pairs. This lone pair is not residing for this carbon. Why? This lone pair electron will be used for this resonance. So that is why here only 3 sigma bonds and 3. That 3 are bond pairs. So this carbon also that will be sp2 hybridized. So here we know all the carbon atoms are sp2 hybridized, therefore this one is planar. Another one is conjugate double bond. Here we know what is conjugate double bonds, alternate single and double bond. So here this one is double bond, single bond, double bond, single bond, then this lone pair, then single bond. So this lone pair will be used for bonding. So this will be same like double bond. So total these electrons are delocalized inside the ring because of this lone pair of electrons. So here it is all the electrons are delocalized. And next is Huckel's rule. Huckel rule, total number of pi electron is 1, 2, 3, 4, and this should be counted as 2, because this is used for bonding. So when this electron is move here, this electron will move here, so it will form a double bond here. So total number of pi electron is 6. 2 plus 2 plus this one is 2. Total 6 pi electrons are here. So n will be 1 and it will satisfy Hückel rule. So this one is cyclic planar. Why it is planar? Because all the carbon atoms are sp2. Here we should not say sp3 because this lone pair is not residing this carbon atom, that is that is used for resonance inside the ring. So this carbon atom doesn't have, because this carbon atom will get n minus 1 number of lone pairs. Here only one lone pair is there, so 1 minus 1 is 0. So this carbon atom is having 0 lone pair. This lone pair will be used for resonance. So only 3 sigma bonds, 3 bond pairs are here. So sp2, 1 plus 2 is 3. So total 3 bond pairs are here. That is why it is sp2 hybridization. So cyclopentadienyl anion is aromatic compound. Next compound is propylium ion or cycloheptatrienyl cation. So here we know this compound is a cyclic compound, because all the atoms are inside the ring. Then it is, next is planar. When a compound is said to be planar, that should satisfy sp2 hybridization or sp. Here we know this one is double bond. So these all carbon atoms having double bond is sp2 hybridized. Then what about this carbon atom? This carbon, we know carbon atom total valency is 4. So this one is 1, this is 2, hydrogen is 3, then one positive charge means 4. So here there is no lone pair, only bond pairs are here. How many bond pairs are here? 1, 2 and 3 bond pairs are here. So 3 bond pair means this carbon atom, 3 bond pair means that will satisfy sp2 hybridization. So we know here all the carbon atoms possess sp2. So that will be planar. Next is conjugate double bonds. Here you know conjugate, whether it is conjugated or not. Here all the carbon atoms will be having alternate single and double bonds. Here he sees double bond, single bond, double bond, single bond. Then here there is no single bond. So instead of that one, we have a positive charge here. So because of this positive charge, electrons will be delocalized inside the ring. How it will be delocalized? Here we know this electron will be shifted towards this carbon. So here we know this electron is shifted towards this carbon, means here it will be double bond and this carbon atom will get positive charge. Then what is next resonance? Here this carbon atom will be, this electron will be shifted to this carbon. So here this will be double bond, here it will be positive charge. So electron will be delocalized inside the ring. So that is conjugated double and single bonds. Next is whether it satisfy Hückel rule. Hückel rule is 4n plus 2 pi electrons. So how many total pi electrons are here? 2, 4, 6 only. Because this one is cation, there is no electron. So total 6 pi electrons are here. So 4 into 1 plus 2 is 6. So n is 1. Therefore, tropelium ion or cycloheptatrienyl cation satisfies Hückel's rule. And that compound is said to be aromatic. Another compound is cyclopropenyl cation. Here this compound is cyclic. First condition satisfied, it is cyclic. And another condition is whether it is planar or not. Here we know double bonded carbon atom. This is sp2 hybridized carbon. This one also sp2 hybridized. And what about this carbon? Here also 1, 2 and 3. 3 single bonds are here. And this one is 3 single bonds are here. That means 3 sigma bonds and this one is cation. So 3 sigma bonds means sp2. Sp2 only 3 hybrid orbitals will be here. So this one is 1, this one is 2 and this one is 3. So this carbon atom also possesses sp2 hybridized. So sp2 hybridized means this will be inside in the same plane. So this compound is planar. Next is conjugated double bonds. Here we know this positive charge is utilized for the conjugation inside the ring. So here this one positive means this electron will be shifted towards this carbon. So this negative and this positive, it will be double bond here and the positive charge will be shifted here. Again, this will be delocalized inside the ring. So this process cyclic, planar and conjugate double bonds. Next is Hückel rule. Total number of pi electrons is only 2. See here, only one pi bond. One pi bond means 2 electrons. So n equal to 0. As I told you already, n is an integer. So n can be 0. So total number of electrons is 2. N equal to 0. Therefore, cyclopropanoyl cation satisfies Huckel rule and this is an aromatic compound. Another type of non-benzenoid compounds are heterocyclic compounds. Heterocyclic means these are cyclic compounds which contain carbon and other elements like sulfur, oxygen and nitrogen in the ring structure. So most of the heteroatoms will be having lone pair of electrons. The first one is pyrrole. We will check whether this pyrrole is an aromatic compound. We know the first condition is cyclic. Here you see all the atoms are inside the ring, so this is a cyclic compound. And the next one is planar. You see here, I told you already, double bonded carbon atom means that you will be having sp2 hybridized. So this carbon is sp2, this carbon also sp2, this carbon is sp2 and this carbon is sp2. What about this NH? What about this nitrogen? Whether here this nitrogen, this atom is sp2 or not? How we know here? Because here the total number of pi electron is 2 plus 2, total 4 electrons are here. And if only these 2-4 electrons are here, that will not satisfy aromaticity because there is no delocalization or there is no conjugation. So for the conjugation, this ring, this lone pair will be used for resonance. So these heterocyclic compounds will be having one or two lone pair of electrons that can be either, it can be used or it cannot be used. If the ring needs the pi electrons, it can be used for delocalization. If the ring doesn't need it, that pi electrons will reside with the atom. So here there is only 4 pi electrons are here. So this lone pair of electron of nitrogen will be used for resonance. So what does it mean? This nitrogen will not be having that lone pair of electron with him. This nitrogen will not be having that lone pair of electrons with him. Why? Because this electron will be utilized for resonance, that is for delocalization. So what is the total number of bonds in nitrogen is 1, then this one is 2 and this hydrogen is 3. So here 3 bond pairs are here. So this hybridization will be sp2. Sp2 means the total 3 hybrid orbitals. So this is 1, this is 2 and this is 3. 3 are bond pairs and 3 are sigma bonds. Here this lone pair of electron cannot be counted here. Why? Because this electron is utilized for resonance. So this electrons will not be with nitrogen, that will be utilized for resonance. So here there is no lone pair, only 3 sigma bonds are here. So 3 sigma bonds only means that will be having sp2 hybridization. So here all the atoms are sp2 hybridized. So that compound will be planar. Next is conjugate double bonds. Here you see double bond, then single bond, then lone pair, single bond, double bond. So here this lone pair of electron will be shifted towards this nitrogen. Then this electron will move towards here. So here positive and this electron here, it will be a double bond. So this lone pair will be converted into double bond. So this can be calculated as total number of pi electron is 2, 4 and this is 6. Because this lone pair is not with nitrogen, it is with the ring. So this will be shifted here. So this will be calculated as a double bond. So total is 2, 4 and 6. You see here, this one, this electron will be shifting towards here. So this carbon will be having, this carbon will be having positive and this lone pair of electron will be shifted towards this carbon. So here it will be a double bond. So that will form a double bond here. It will be a double bond here. Then here it will be negative charge. Then again this electron will be shifting towards this carbon. So here it will be positive, positive, negative, it will be a double bond. So electron will be delocalized inside the ring. Therefore, this lone pair now changes as a double bond. So total number of pi electron is 2 plus 2 plus 2, that is 6 pi electrons. So n equal to 1. Therefore, pyrrole is an aromatic compound. Next compound is thiophene. thiophene having sulfur atom. The hetero atom is sulfur with the two lone pairs of electron. This is again cyclic. Here it is planar. How it is planar? Because we know this double bonded carbon atom is sp2 hybridized, and this sulfur atom. Now you see here sulfur atom, two lone pairs are here. So one lone pair is used for resonance. So how many lone pairs will be residing with sulfur? Only one, because n minus 1 is the total number of lone pairs that will be excess with the atom. So if there are two lone pairs are here, one lone pair will be with the sulfur atom. If only one lone pair will be here, there will not be any lone pair with the sulfur atom. So here for sulfur, there are two lone pairs are here. Therefore, one lone pair will be used for resonance with the ring. So this sulfur atom will be having again one lone pair. So here these all carbon atoms will be sp2 hybridized. And this lone pair will be utilized for resonance. So sulfur will be having one lone pair with it. So just see here, 1, 2 bond pair and one lone pair is with the sulfur atom. So again this sulfur atom will be having sp2 hybridization. Why it is sp2 hybridization? Because here sulfur atom will be having two bond pair and one lone pair. So 2 plus 1, 2 bond pair and one lone pair means 2 plus 1, total 3. So this sulfur is again sp2 hybridized. So all the atoms are in sp2 hybridization, and this one is planar. Then conjugate double bonds, we know this double bond, this lone pair is used for resonance, so this will be changed as a double bond. So total number of pi electron is 2, 4, and this one is 2, 6. So n equal to 1, so this will obey Huckel rule, and therefore thiophene is an aromatic compound. So next compound is pyridine. This one also cyclic, then planar. Here you know all the carbon atoms are sp2 hybridized. Here total number of pi electron is 6. Therefore this lone pair of electron of nitrogen is not used for resonance. So that will result with the nitrogen atom. So here we know this carbon is sp2, this one is sp2, this one is sp2. All the carbon atoms are sp2. And what about this nitrogen? Nitrogen having 1, 2 bond pairs and one lone pair is with them. So 2 bond pair and 1 lone pair. So here this one also having sp2 hybridization. So all the carbon atoms and this nitrogen is having sp2 hybridization, and therefore it is planar. Then we know this conjugated double bond is there. Total number of pi electron is only 6. We cannot use this lone pair of nitrogen because this lone pair of nitrogen is not used for resonance. There is no need of this lone pair of electrons as it has already 6 electrons are here. So n equal to 1. So pyridine satisfies Huckel rule, planarity and cyclic compound, and is having conjugated double bond. So this compound is said to be aromatic. Another type of non-benzenoid compound is anilines. What are anilines? These are monocyclic conjugated polyenes containing 10 or more carbon atoms into the ring are called anilines. So anilines are monocyclic compounds but having more than 10 carbon atoms in the ring, and they are generally named by prefixing the number of carbon atoms placed in square brackets, like 14 aniline, 18 aniline. 14 means the number of carbon atoms in the monocyclic ring, and that will be conjugated polyenes. An example of aniline is 14 aniline. Here we know 14 aniline means here total number of carbon atoms will be 14. And this one is cyclic, as you know here, this one is cyclic. And here all the carbon atoms, here alternate single and double bond is here. So these carbon atoms possess sp2 hybridization. Therefore this one is planar. Then conjugate double bond. Here all the bonds are conjugated. Double bond, single bond, double bond, single bond. So here electrons are delocalized inside the ring. Then how many pi bonds are here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Total 7 pi bonds are here. So total 14 pi electrons are here. So 14 pi electrons means 4 into 3 plus 2. So n equal to 3. Total number of pi electron is 14. So this compound is aromatic. So 14 aniline satisfies Huckel rule and is said to be aromatic. So dear students, now let us discuss this one. This compound is cyclopentadiene. We will discuss whether this compound is aromatic. We know the first condition is cyclic, so this one is cyclic compound. Another condition is that should be planar. Whether, please check whether it is planar or not. Here you know double bonded carbon atom is sp2, so this one is sp2, this one is sp2, this one is sp2, and this one is sp2. So what about this carbon atom? Just see here, what about this carbon? We know total valency of carbon is 4. So here it will be having two more bonds. So these two bonds will be hydrogen. So this will be hydrogen and this also will be hydrogen. So these two bonds are hydrogen, means total four sigma bonds are here. So here total, see, 1, 2, 3, 4. So total 4 sigma bonds means this carbon atom will be sp3 hybridized. So sp3 hybridized means this compound is not planar. Another condition is conjugate double bonds are here. You know double bond, single bond, again single bond. So here there is no conjugation also. So this part is having conjugation, this part is not having conjugation. So this not satisfy planarity, this will not satisfy conjugation. And the total number of electron is 4. Total, because 2 pi bonds are here, that will be 4n. But even if it is 4n pi electrons, we cannot say this one is anti-aromatic, as the compound is not planar and that will not be having conjugate double bonds. So dear students, today we have discussed Huckel rule of aromaticity for benzenoid and non-benzenoid compounds. Thank you for watching. Please like, comment and subscribe for more videos.